She's got them right here.
Oh, I see.
She's going to her prom.
Would you like to see the name that first on the list?
At the women's retreat, yes. You got it. Mrs. is
perfect. Oh, well, I did it.
Yeah.
Clara Rose is the other guy.
You want to pass out? You got another one of those cards you want to pass out?
About
nobody watching?
Super skis. I did it for 2 days.
Special for your anniversary?
No.
I got a girl's earball.
Found a punch, huh?
Yeah. You hit it. You need to come on this side.
Let's do this. a sweat here.
You want our Debbie to look at
the And I'm going to sweat. They're too nervous.
They don't want bread punch.
You're in front of all of them.
principally a gas.
Always want to be. Keeping those TV cameras rolling?
You should have bought the one night.
Stands at his normal position.
Who's that, Daddy? Is that your daddy? Is that daddy? Oh, she's sleepy. Just a big yawn.
Your brother Mike.
Is everybody in New Orleans? Hi. gonna talk, stop talking, we're gonna sing to you. Okay, that's impossible. Well, by special request, some of you that were here for our service this morning, Sherry and I sang songs, well, appropriate for this time of the year. And it's all about Christmas and Christ coming down for his glory to go into a lowly manger and someday to die for our sins. But I think Betty really enjoys this song. So we're going to sing it for you, whether you want to listen back there or not. tape ready. This is kind of something kind of spontaneous out of love for his wife. Honestly. But I know there's a lot of, probably some funny things I know you could relate to the rest of us about Betty and Ardevia. And I'm sure Homer has something.
I'm going to do this because Ardevia likes it so well.
They were both working for Hallmark's. And we had rules and rules at our house. You come in and when you're through with your job, you come home. Or the other alternative, you call me and tell me what you are doing at all times. And they always, Elizabeth was a good girl. She always did that. But sometimes there were people who led her astray. Night, we had company, which made it easy anyway. My sister was here, and it's 2 o'clock. They work till 1, see? 2 o'clock, she's not home yet, and it's 2:30, and she's still not home yet, and it's getting toward 3, and suddenly we hear this car pull up outside, and they're laughing and giggling, and I open the door, and R.W. is running up, carrying Elizabeth. And I opened the door real fast, and I said, I have had enough of this. And I don't want this. And he drops her just like a hot potato. And he says, oh, Mrs. Rule, I will never do this again. Believe me, I will never do it again. You can count on that. He never did. I don't know.
That was the biggest mistake we ever made. I tell you what, it's because she said,
because I said,
you just come in here and eat instead of going
said,
to the restaurant.
Just go to the restaurant to eat. After all, it's only an hour.
We never had anything in a refrigerator for that.
I said, okay, you can have the kitchen so I can go to bed. So that's what they did from then on.
For being such a good friend to me.
Hard to live.
She wanted one of these old songs. I wish she'd just buy one of her records, but she won't do that. So we're going to do a song that's on it. It's called Let Christ Be.
Let Christ Be there in your life. Let it be there in your life. And change mama's life. And let his children share.
Serious. A lot of sacrifices that happen in 25 years of anybody's life.
Did you see our
a lot of those sacrifices are for each other, and I know some of those sacrifices have been for us. And we appreciate that. We love you both. But the greatest sacrifice that you both have made, and that we all make in our lives, is when we present our bodies and our lives a living sacrifice to the Lord. And that's what this song's about.
Sherry for singing for me and Stan and Judy. It's our life, the things that they've sung about, and that's what I believe has kept us together. Because there's been days I couldn't stand here and say that it's just all been roses, because you all know how it is. But because of God first in our life, I believe that's the answer. So thank you all for coming, and please visit, and please eat up all the cake. We don't want to take any home.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Which one?
Sure. No, she wants the camera.
6 more years
of
law.
Oops.
Get him.
Here he comes.
Yeah. Yeah. I can't help you there, man. Rochelle could.
Worth a lift ticket for a couple days,
huh?
Sam's ought to give you at least a couple of days lift ticket on that one. You ought to get a couple of days lodging out of that plate set.
I don't have anything else to do.
Well, I don't know. It's getting harder and harder each year.
Hours and hours filming basketball games.
Teaching people who are in the doghouse be responsible by just making a responsible statement.
This button is a on button for recording. These two buttons, this one's Zoom.
Well, you know what's
really bad?
You
just think
of
flung out in
front
of the family.
The wedding
book,
you cut the
teeth
off the wedding
book
and you said,
It'd be a fantastic way to keep the stage.
Gee, thanks, Pat.
Oh, did you see my roses?
Every week.
Did you know she was going
to be here?
Not from him. Who are you
from? From Shirley. I've never gotten roses from him. That would be a big surprise.
Oh, I hope you buy some food for him.
Well, you can get it away from him.
Don't let Donnie get all my food.
Okay, go ahead. Shut that thing off and I ran in front of it.
So what are you going to do then?
Surely there's such thing as a silver rod and reel. Yeah. Or a box of silver paint shotgun shells or something like that.
Is that from Ruth, too?
Lone Ranger.
What'd you do, buy off any property or something?
If you can't hit those pheasants, you can scare them.
There's three silver candy. At least give them a fancy letter. Send them off.
Are you recording? Just lay it.
Hey, what you
doing? By noon the next day.
Carl was telling me about all them pheasant farms they got out there in western Kansas. That's why you like to go out there.
That's Stan telling you that story.
No. Carl was telling me about it.
But we kind of worked on that together. I heard it wasn't a story. The real one's at Clay Center. That's where the real pheasants are. They got 10,000 out there. Yeah.
This is, you know, going to take me for Christmas.
true stories. Lauren.
Is I 30 yeah. Is I 35 or something?
The first 25.
To the director, and she's sitting over there.
Are you going to do a monologue?
You're going to read them later. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I have one in there.
This one's a pretty good one. This one doesn't tell you when it's recorded. There's usually a red light up here.
I didn't think you had that on. I don't think it's recorded.
Get Grandma Nancy over there.
No, because he's spinning around. He's playing games right now. You better get that on Betty. She's opening up some important cargo.
Okay, just get in there. Get in. If we care. Just tear it all up.
That's the only time he's turning it on is when.
Crawling over boxes and boxes. Yeah, about 11:30. She's still going strong.
Oh, Lisa, did Lauren enjoy her wrappings more than her gifts?
Battle of Lord.
She'll go to the table for 2 o'clock. Keep the papers in the
fridge. Your mother will be grabbing that.
From Shirley and Wayne.
Yeah.
We'll mail that to you.
Is it refrigerated? No, it's a hanging.
This is the sleeping room. The sleeping room.
But you know,
Lord, don't want to say it, darling.
Okay, hold that thing here.
Well, since we parked glass of water,
hold it straight.
Her around all day long and do whatever
would
she
to build something and decide not to build
it. And to my mother, who I know spent an hour and a half making the boat for the ninth. That's what my sister-in-law said.
I told on you, Mom.
And made all the pretty bows. Okay. And made the table look pretty, along with Lisa. And to my sister, who paid for it all.
It's probably true, too.
It is. Thank you, Ruth. I have to thank you because you did it all for me.
Well, Elizabeth, I'm such a truthful person. I cannot tell a lie. I went over to the door, and your father says, Marlene, you know.
Yeah.
She says, she's making a bow. I said, what do you get for making a bow? She says, oh, 50 cents. He says, you got 3 of them to make. Oh. So she just made 3 of them real quick.
Boy, she made them. Oh, yeah, she made them in a hurry.
We decided if we're on our way to Kansas City, where we're supposed to be, we better do that.
Yeah. That's well, all. They'd be hard to work with, too.
To my brother and sister-in-law for singing, who it's real hard to get them to sing for me, but I managed to do it.
Well, every 25 years, they'll break down and do it for you, Elizabeth, so, you know, not for another 25. We have a long time to practice between
Then on my 50th, I want you to do "To God Be the Glory."
And bring the choir, right?
Bring the choir.
And the trumpets and the horn.
Okay. Right. Right. Yeah, the thing that high part.
Yeah.
The what?
You're talking about the one.
To God Be the Glory.
To God Be the Glory.
Isn't there a girl in it that's a very high part?
Not in that one.
Well, I don't know if it's on that one.
And Pat, thank you very much for all you went through with the flowers. She made all the flowers and the flower arrangement. And she made the Christmas arrangement over there for me. That's a funny special thing for me. Goes along with her.
Well, he's followed me for 31 years. And somebody else, surely.
We spent her 25th anniversary down on the river.
No, we went to church.
We went to church?
We spent all the other
We went to church on 25th. I thought we were down there. I lost track which one it was.
Surely.
Oh, sure. She's not here, but she made the cake. Did you all get a piece of cake?
No, the cake was a piece of cake. Now you want a piece of Shirley's cake.
Yes. There's a cake over there.
Shirley's cake was over there?
Yeah, eat a piece of cake. She made the sheet cake. And Jean and Roy came, and they just put everything together here for me and gave me, and I appreciate that. And Nancy came and did all the dishes. Cleaned up the kitchen at the church.
I think it's neat the people that come early to see if there's anything.
I
thought that's so typical.
Very seldom mention it.
And to me, poured punch at my wedding 25 years ago.
In the same dress.
Same color. Same color.
Kenny wasn't around then. And I don't know if Jim, yeah, Jim was at our wedding. He was in a, that's not me. I was going to say, I don't know whether Jim made it that day. But he could give us good. But
this is the result of all this, isn't it cute?
Both of them are results.
See how long we last.
Anyway, it's been a fun day.
You know, Jana was leading you kids at the church. Here.
Lots of fun.
Did
she get to
make a cookie? She probably liked it too.
She did. John and
Debbie called
her
this morning.
They have paid somebody. We'll all been out there. I'll figure this way.
And then you have to break them of it between you. Time from time.
As of yesterday, she was playing.
You see it.
See, that's a pretty.
This guy ran the vacuum for you.
Oh, I forgot the vacuum.
She goes there and throws it on the floor and stands there.
We know he can do it.
Are you doing her today? Oh, yes, at Grandma's house.
I can do it.
She
has to do that
for me. That's why you're taking that clip.
That he was.
He was saying this clip.
I know he was.
Now he looks out.
Yeah, he looks out.
Yeah,
he looks out.
I've done that twice, sir, lately.
Yeah, he looks out.
Yeah,
he looks
out.
And I know our Debbie's thanking me for telling the story for him.
he said you're
going to get a lot of that. I really feel bad that I didn't say some real good things. Because, you know, he put me in a garbage disposal.
He put you in one, tried to cut you up 5 years ago.
And the thing is, Lord, but he's now brought me another used one.
Learn how to put that garbage.
Now, how many think that the son-in-law ought to go ahead and continue?
How many think? Are we voting?
I'll tell you what I've done. I jumped right in there and got Drano and poured down the old one and just let it keep draining out of it.
All he says is, well, your dad just thinks all he can't do is the wiring. Yeah, that's all. He can probably screw it up in the... I can probably do that.
What'd you get? Right out the back door?
Oh, last time I bought a garbage.
He really likes to hear that story. He thinks it's good.
It is a pill to change from one to another.
Right. Well, no, it all turned out pretty good.
I thought you meant you bought a his and hers.
No. I told somebody today,
I was incited by Maxine was there and yeah, her kids were not the quite as old as she was. She
took the short. Yeah.
Stan's playing Davy Crockett here.
Stuff, actually. It's too far away to be.
Yeah, a little bit too much.
been there for a while.
I'm
much better when I
go down there. And I thought we'd eat everything up.
You have to go
down there. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Every morning, I work on me all day.
He says,